California is running out of water. 90% of the state is experiencing an exceptional drought, and they are facing one of the worst water shortages in history. How did the conditions get so bad, and how will this impact the state's water supply for years to come? California experienced a very mild spring and summer, which caused this historic drought to begin. Due to the lack of rain and extremely hot temperatures, the ground began to dry out. In San Jose, they have only seen half their normal rainfall this year, which has diminished any hope that rainwater could help alleviate some of the water reservoirs. San Francisco declared a water emergency and called for a 10% reduction across the water usage system. At this point, you may be thinking, is the water shortage occurring because of California's water distribution system, or because of a physical shortage of clean drinking water? When it comes to water distribution, California's water system is broken down into three different aqueducts. The Colorado River Aqueduct comes down from the Colorado River and serves 19 million people. Branching off from the Colorado River Aqueduct is the California Aqueduct, serving another 19 million residents. A third supply line branches off from both of these aqueducts, the Los Angeles Aqueduct. It comes directly down from the other two and serves nearly 4 million residents. This aqueduct is responsible for filling the enormous 2.5 billion gallon LA Reservoir. This is the iconic reservoir where the city of Los Angeles placed over 90 million black shade balls over the surface to prevent evaporation. Most of California's aqueducts were built during the 19th century, ranging from the early 1900s to the 1960s. But these water supply systems were not designed in the most efficient way, having to pump water up and down different elevations throughout California. This results in a lot of electricity being needed to supply the power to pump water up very high elevations throughout the California mountains. When the water finally reaches the nearly 1,500 reservoirs throughout California, dams are used to equally distribute the water so it does not overfill and back up the supply lines. But because of the 2021 drought, there is no threat of overfilling. The dams are letting through as much water as possible and letting it get to the reservoirs to then be pumped out to locations across California. With no slowdown in the water usage by California's residents, the situation began to get out of control. In late September, officials in Marin County, California, were competing with the Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia to try and purchase three portable water desalination plants. The crisis is so bad that state officials would be willing to take water directly from the ocean using desalination plants and then add it back into the reservoirs throughout the state. Most of California's water needs actually go to farming, with 80% of the state's fresh water going to farms and only 20% to the population. The aging water system is one of the causes to the very slow delivery of fresh water throughout California, since most of them were constructed over a century ago. For years, residents in California have been warned of a looming water crisis, but the situation has never gotten to this extent. The satellite images you're seeing show the sheer amount of water that has evaporated from lakes throughout California. While these images show at least some water in the lakes, others have completely dried up, with no water left to pump out for treatment. So where does the situation go from here? With lakes empty and a lot of stress on California's water supply line, how can this problem be resolved, and what can California do to prevent this in the future? The main supplier of California's aqueducts is the Colorado River, which declared its first water shortage in August of 2021. Supplying nearly 40 million people across four states, the river cannot keep up with the intense needs of a state like California. According to NOAA, there is nearly a 50-50 chance at what will happen to California's water supply this winter, with some forecasting enough precipitation to end the drought and others forecasting that it will continue. January is when California sees its most precipitation, and they will desperately need it to replenish their water supply line throughout the state. But looking at California as a whole, there are various opinions about the state's future with the water system at its current capacity. With a rising population, will the state be able to support more people during long-term droughts like this one? Or is California's water supply nearly at a tipping point? Only time will tell if California's water supply line will be able to face a crisis like this for much longer. On the other side of California is the Port of Los Angeles, which is going through a completely different crisis. Over 70 cargo ships are backed up off the Port of Los Angeles, causing supply chain issues across the world. To learn more about why the port is so backed up, click the video here. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe if you enjoyed the video.